Welcome to episode 81 of Diecast TV Channel.
Welcome to another unboxing video. This time we've received a package from our friend Tortoise Tom 1 in the US. Now this is his end of a trade that we've worked out. So let's cut the tape and we'll see what's inside. Okay, we're back. We've just cut the tape. Let's have a look and see what's inside. Oh, I see some muscle machines here. We don't have muscle machines in our collection, so this will be interesting to see what we've got. So I'll take out the first one, and Eagle, if you can just have a look at the other ones there. So it says 2003 New York, just get that label down, New York Toy Fair car. Wow, that's pretty cool. It's a Honda. Very nice. Look at the graphics on that, and the interior is all painted red. It's got the NYTF 2003 logo just down there. Oh, thanks very much. That's certainly something unusual and interesting to add to our Japanese diecast collection. So thanks very much for that.
Next, we've got a Super 09 Ford Focus RS.
Right, so this one was what we've organised for the trade. So we've received this 09 Ford Focus RS Super Treasure Hunt for 2012. Beautiful. So I was still needing this one. Eagle and Falcon already have received one of these, but this one will be added to my collection. So thanks, Tortoise Tom 1, that's awesome. Up
we
next.
We have some music things.
Oh,
we
so this is part of the music series. The jukebox, HW jukebox, you can see just on there.
So
there's quite a few cars in the series. And we're particularly keen on the hip-hop Honda, that was our favourite one. But we've got the whole series here by the look of things. So the first one, what's that? That's a 56 Flash Cider.
Rock and Roll.
Rock and Roll, that's right, Falcon. What's the next one?
The Grunge.
Grunge.
95 Camaro.
Yep, 95 Camaro. I wonder how they picked these cars, how they decided which one was the grunge one and which was the rock and roll and hip-hop.
We've got two hip-hop Hondas.
And two hip-hop Hondas, fantastic. Now we did receive three of these just recently from our friend D-Collector777, but these are absolutely fantastic. Now we can have an opener as well. Absolutely love the look of these cars. And they've got painted tail lights, nice matte roof and bonnet there. Great tempos on the side. Sorry, camera doesn't have macro, so can't hold it too close to the camera.
Next we
have... thank you, that's great. Yeah, what have we got next?
It looks like a drag pedal.
Oh my goodness, wow. Oh wow, that's excellent. This is one of the Redline Club cars, I believe. One of the ones you can only get on for mail-ins, I think. I'll check on that and just make sure, but that's my understanding. We certainly can't get these here in New Zealand. So this is a custom 56 Volkswagen drag beetle. Wow, this looks spectacular in that. It's got like a green Spectraflame paint job, painted tail lights. Fantastic. Thank you so much, Tortoise Tom 1. And it's in a Protecto as well, so I appreciate you sending on Protecto packs, because we don't get these plastic Protectos here as well, so when we receive them, we definitely can keep the cars in them, so that's absolutely awesome. Thanks.
Next up, we've got a 32 Ford sedan delivery.
Oh, neat. Yeah, again, we don't get this series. And this is a really nice car. I sort of saw these on some of the other videos on YouTube around Christmas time. And I saw a few, I thought they'd make great Christmas tree decorations and put them out at Christmas time. So, tell you what, this one we can use for the 2013 Christmas and put it out on display. So thank you so much, that's awesome.
Next we've got the black racing team bone shaker.
Wow, a black, yep, black mainline bone shaker there on US card.
Next we've got a Redline 69 Dodge Charger.
Oh right, so this is part of one of the exclusive series that is only available in the US with the Redline wheels. And I'm told that Ocala, Florida is actually a real place. So So it says Ocala, Florida on the side there.
Next we got the 77 Pontiac Firebird.
Looks like Smokey and the Bandit's Firebird. Awesome. That's a really good casting, this one. And definitely no longer available here in the shops. Okay, and Falcon's looking pretty excited here beside me. He's just pointed out these three Ectos. Now, I'll tell you what, this is one car. When we first started collecting in 2008, we collected the models that we liked. And when this model came out, we did like it, but we weren't that fussed on it. So we ended up not getting any in the end. And so this was one car, one film and sort of TV movie car that we didn't actually pick up. We've got all the, Back to the Future, obviously the Smokey and the Bandit, Mystery Machine, that sort of thing, but we just never picked up the Ecto-1, and it's something we always regretted. And so I can see here that you've sent three cars, one for each of us. So thank you so much. That's absolutely fantastic. Really, really appreciate that. Really unusual, because it's got all these clip-on parts on top, on the roof. Okay, and next, some Team Hot Wheels. Love the Ford Fiesta. Of course, we're big fans of Ken Block, the rally driver. He watches Gymkhana videos. So Ford Fiesta is an awesome casting. Brilliant. And what have you got over there, Eagle?
Yeah. I've just set up a whole lot of older vehicles.
Some loose older vehicles. So when we did the trade with Tortoise Tom, he mentioned to us that he had some extras, some spares that he might send our way. And I was amazed, that he would even think about giving up some of these. So I don't know what these are yet. I'll just have a quick look through. And what I'll do is I'll do some research online, and I'll see if I can find out what the models are and put them down the bottom of the screen. But that's obviously got some red line tyres on there. It looks cool. I like the military look of that.
Now this model, or this casting, is easily recognised here. The Thunder Roller.
The Thunder Roller. I can't believe you sent me your Thunder Roller, Tortoise Tom one. Oh, absolutely awesome. I love the Thunder Roller. Thank you so much. That's absolutely fantastic. And look at the condition on it too. It's like it's new. Honestly, that is amazing. Thank you so much.
Now this looks pretty cool. It's a Chevrolet Impala from the Cleveland Police Force.
I'll just put that one there. Okay, on to the next one. So, an Impala. As you say, from Cleveland Police.
It's a Matchbox model.
So if I'm not mistaken, Cleveland might be in Ohio, where Tortoise Tom won. I think that's where you're from. Oh, what a fantastic model that is. Thank you so much. That'll go well in on a little playmat with our rest of our cars.
Now this next casting is named P911 and has a copyright of 1974.
So yes, this is a Porsche. That will be what the P is. 911. Porsche 911. Wow. It's got the Hot Ones wheels on it by the look of things.
Looks
and it's
really
actually
cool.
Yeah, it looks like a genuine sort of vintage Hot Wheels car. Again, I don't know a lot about this car. It looks absolutely stunning. So I'll find out and I'll put some more information down the bottom there.
Now this next casting, I'm not too sure what it is, but it's very rare to get these motorbikes in the back of it now.
Yeah, it looks like some, maybe a 56 Ford F100, something like that. There's no model number on the base there. So again, I'll do some research and I'll put the details down the bottom of which model this is. But I have a feeling that this is probably quite rare. It's got black wool wheels there. And as Eagle just said, it's got motorbikes in the back, and the motorbikes are in perfect condition. There's no damage, no bent handlebars or anything like that, which is quite unusual for something old to remain in such good condition all this time.
Now this next casting is a battle-scarred A-Team van.
A battle-scarred, yeah.
Oh, wow. Now, I did mention to Tortoise Tom that one of my grail pieces is the A-Team van with real riders. And he said, well, I do actually have one of those that I might be able to send your way. Spare one. So, oh, I really appreciate this. This is absolutely fantastic. So you can see how they used the Baja Breaker casting here. And they've done it up like the A-Team. And it even has the opening hood on it here, this little plastic piece. That is absolutely awesome. I know it's seen a bit of play wear and things like that, but oh, I love it. It's absolutely brilliant. Thank you so much. Really appreciate getting this. These are, I know, so hard to find. I've never seen one for sale here. So I really appreciate being able to get one for my collection.
Now this next casting, I have no idea what the model is, but it looks quite cool.
Yeah, so it's a tow truck. It sort of looks a bit like the super van at the front. but I have seen this one before. It doesn't seem to have any details on the bottom again about what model it is. But I do believe that this is definitely a vintage piece. It's got the black wall wheels.
Larry's 24-hour towing.
Yeah, so it says on there, Larry's 24-hour towing on the sides. So we'll do some more research and we'll find out. Just look down the bottom of the screen and see what we've found out about this model. And as we collect more vintage, our own knowledge will grow further. So thank you very much for sending us that. That's excellent.
Now this guy here is named Turbofire. And it is what I believe a 1968 vintage Hot Wheels car.
Oh, wow. Turbofire. Yeah, so I see it's got redline wheels. And it's possible this could actually be an original redline. So again, we'll do some more research on this one and find out more about it. If so, if this is genuine, this would be our second Hot Wheels original car. Oh, I can't believe that. That's amazing. Thank you so much for sending us something, you know, so unusual. So vintage. And as we can see, the back here, the engine cover will lift up and there's an engine in there. Wow, and it's in good condition. It rolls really well. And similar with this one. Okay, this one looks quite vintage too. Maybe not so old as the Turbo Flame here. I'm just looking for a model name on here. No model name on the bottom there, but we'll do the research again and we'll put that down the bottom of the screen. It definitely looks like it's something that a little kid would play with in the 80s, or maybe in the 70s perhaps. Rolls well still. Quite an unusual car, isn't it? It's a bit of a wedge shape, but it looks like it's built for racing. It's got a plastic base and a metal body, and you can see it originally had some orange and orange border here with some stars cut out into the graphics. And some pink or crimson and a red Hot Wheels logo right there on the front. And a number 3 in the star up the back here. Wow, what an awesome mix of cars that you've sent us, Tortoise Tom 1.
Thanks.
So, yeah, we'll just have a quick look at this and see what we've got. What did you say, Eagle?
I was about to say, thanks heaps for the awesome assortment of cars. We got new to old and just... It's just a fantastic package you put together for us.
Thank you, Tortoise Tom 1, for those Ghostbusters Ecto-1s.
What a fantastic trade. Thank you so much.
That's it for episode 81 of DCTV Channel. Thank you to all of our channel viewers and subscribers for watching. And Tortoise Tom 1, thank you very much for trading with us. You've sent some incredible cars from your own collection here, and we really, really appreciate it. All the best from the team of three at DCTV.